So this is the latest official AOSP based Android 10 beta or developer preview build update for ASUS Zenfone Lite L1, Live L1 and Live L2. We have a video tutorial to illustrate the installation process. It's actually expected one, but in an unexpected time. I have been using this for last 2 weeks. So here are my thoughts on the in-depth look, episode number 24. This video is not just like earlier, just mentioning merits and cons, but also seeing some use cases and the individual views. This is actually not fulfilled Android 10, it's developer preview and we got to know by fixing the navigation bar. Actually, it would be Google's developer preview 3 made for ASUS Zenfone Lite or Live phones, but it's compiled with the latest March 5th, 2020 Android security patch level. The thing ASUS did is just made this phone also like Max M1 Pro and M2 Pro, which all are running in stock Android. Yes, of course, these are direct AOSP builds which has no customization. You can add these into Xiaomi Mi A series phones. Comparing these things with Pixel or OxygenOS is totally top comedy. That's a part. Well, we start with the advantages of updating it. Still, there are some users who have not unlocked their device but want to take a look on stock Android. It's a great opportunity for those who want to install it as it doesn't require root or PC. But just to let you know that you might need a PC or unlocked bootloader to revert back to old stock version in the case of issues. Without unlocking bootloader, its question is to revert back to the old version. I haven't tried it. Second, we have two official options. One is Zenue Vario and another one is Pi Beta. I actually recommend both for daily usage, but things are changing in its own way. We see Pi Beta has its own problems like app crashing, poor app management, and we have a list. Also, Vario builds. They seems like good in the beginning, but as the days go, it's like an old horse. There are some features in Zenue I personally use, but there are more than that I don't even consider. In terms of AOSP, there is no extraordinary thing to recommend, but the device's past builds are making us consider this as one of the good opportunity. I personally like Zenue more than MIUI. It's ad free and the Zen Fixlr camera, which I like the most and use the most. Also, the Zen Audio Wizard, one of the great audio tweaks for the device, makes the audio crisp and loud. You might think why he is talking about Zenue in AOSP update video. Well, it is the reason. You miss all of them in AOSP. We already made a video on AOSP review. Same applies here. In terms of Android 10 GSI, you won't get the VoLTE. But here, it works perfectly. So you can use Jio without any apps. There is no audio issue while on call in this build. There are some considerations you have to think about before you update to AOSP. The good part and the takeaway is updated Android, lightweight, dark mode, night light, digital well-being, fully Google enabled features, and it goes. Well, now we discuss this build. After the update, the power on screen changed from ASUS to powered by Android. We have AOSP launcher and one camera app where I am unable to find the name of it. It looks like a combination of Fixlr camera and the AOSP, but it's working decent. But as usual, you can use open camera along with the Gcam. There is no inbuilt file manager or gallery app. They are providing files and photos. That's fine. I would suggest additionally using a third party file managers like Solid Explorer, make it work normally. Like Zenue, here too we are having sheets, spreadsheet and all. I have uninstalled and disabled all of them. In the beginning, you will get 8GB usable storage to save your personal stuffs. There is no any audio equalizer app to control the effects. The default normal output is normal. It's not as good as Zenue's one. It may look loud but not crisp. How about battery backup? Well, it's same like earlier, giving 4 to 5 hours of screen on time. It will come 3.5 hour to 4 hour of continuous screen on time while gaming. But the annoying thing here is the battery energy is happening even when you don't use the phone. If you charge fully and put it the device straight 3 days, you will left with no juice. Air consumption in the background is a little high compared to Zen UI. It's not well optimized. Sometime I left night with more than 50% of battery, but the next morning it will be like in low battery. It happened for me. It can be easily fixed by putting in a battery saver or using some kernel editor and tweak, but that's a hiccup here. How about the performance and app management? To be honest, it's better than any other earlier builds and GSI. The performance was the main thing here in AOSP update. It's good and the best. The flow rate is high while switching between apps. I really like the performance here. The app manager improved a lot. You can switch between 2 to 3 apps. They run in background without any problem. What about the overall thing? Well, it has both sides. Less features but good stability. Yes, I said it's stable, but we have some issues like face unlock. It's totally broke. It's not usable anymore. The double tap to wake up and lift the phone to wake up features are enabled defaultly, but they work abnormally. So that's actually annoying. It suddenly vibrates. Sometimes the screen goes off. It happened for me. I tried to turn it off, but I'm unable to find the option to do. Sometimes while I was in call, the screen will off and won't turn on. Maybe the issue is with the sensor. I don't know exactly because no one faced that issue. Hotspot and Wi-Fi, it's working normally. Well, my recommendation. As I said, there are two set of people. One who unlocked the device, they definitely can try this build. It's good and usable for daily usage. As normal, things like camera, audio, call and network, battery performance is fine. For gamers, regarding the performance, I have uploaded the gaming performance test video. Just check to get some idea. And the one who have not unlocked their device, they also can try, but it's not Zen UI, it's AOSP. So there are some features you might miss. Those I covered in earlier part of this video. But if you know how to flash things and get it normal, well, you are ready to go. Install and take a look at stock family. If you have any queries, concerns, please leave in the comment. If you want any extra assistance and update regarding things, follow and connect with me on Instagram at techfanzier. I'm continuously looking into this build to improve quality and performance. I would have missed some small things to mention, but that's about. Let me know if you are facing any issue in the comment. That can help others a lot. Thank you for watching. Code Mato.